All right. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Season 2 Recap Show. As you see here is the Empower Championship final league standings. As you see, Hartlepool, we finished in first with 103 points, 7 points above second place Southampton. We'll go to the statistics here. As you see, Poole wound up winning the Golden Boot with 20 goals on the season, just edging out Rodriguez. I don't even think we have anybody else on this list, and we don't. As for assists, we got a few guys. As you see, Gnabry led our team with 7 assists. And Pompilio and Loughton in there with 6. Do we have anybody else on here? No. Clean sheets. Cragnell finished in 2nd, as you see, with 16. I actually think Torres might be on this list as well. Yeah, there he is. He had 5. So not bad for the backup. I don't think we had anything in here with yellow or red cards again. Let's go with team statistics. Hartlepool. As for goals, Pool 20. Once again, spread the love. Pompilio was 2nd with 7. Gnabry was 6. Lanzini was 6. Carmona with 5. Redmond 5. 3. As you see there, Portillo, he only got in 2 games and his only goal was that penalty at the end there. James only had 1 goal. Kind of a disappointing season, I'd say. Yeah, we had a lot of guys score goals this season. Same thing with assists. Zero yellow cards. The best average. Dembele up there in 2nd. Let's see who wound up having the worst out of the guys that played a lot. Wow. Look at that. 3 left midfielders were the worst guys. That's pretty bad. Alright, let's see here. Tottenham did wind up winning the FA Cup, in case anyone was concerned. As for the squad report, here we go. As you see, Cragnow jumped 4 places to a 67. Dembele jumped 5 places up to a 74. Look at that. We got him for 2.8 million. He's now worth 10. So I'd say that's a pretty good return on our investment. Hartley moved up 3 to a 73. He might be one of the guys that's expendable only because he's 26. Saget, who we got as a free transfer in the beginning of the season, moved up 5 to a 68. I guess I could also show these stats. Let's go back up. And I don't know, like Fisher, he's got that exclamation point. I think that's some kind of glitch. But as you see, Redmond moved up 3. He's got pretty good acceleration. One of the few guys that has the dark green in any of their stats. Goretzka moved up 3 to a 71. Loughton, who was also a pickup as a free transfer, free agent, he moved up 6 to a 70. Ocampos moved up 2 to a 72. Fisher moved up 4 to a 76. He might be arguably our best player in terms of overall, as you see his value's up to 12 million now. Poole's up 4 to a 71. Depe is up 3 to a 75. Now he's also got a good acceleration. Oh, we got Portillo moved up 1. That's pretty good. Looking at his stats, he's got pretty good pace. I didn't realize that. Franks moved up 4 to a 67. Once again, the guy who I'm not even going to try to pronounce his name moved up 5 to a 66. He's also a guy that we got on a free transfer. Juve moved up 5 to a 65. His stamina still is awful. 41. Lancini, whose stamina is even worse at a 38, moved up 3 to a 66. Serge Gnabry, look at that, that's a pretty good jump, up 5 to a 66. Luska moved up 5 as well to a 68. I didn't realize how good he was doing. Sayudo moved up 3 to a 61. He's a guy that I'm going to try to get transferred out. I don't mean sell him, but possibly like a season-long loan deal. Pompilio moved up 3 to a 66. Nilsson moved up 3 to a 61. He's the guy that I'm trying to offload. 61 just ain't going to cut it in the Premier League. Merg moved up 4 to a 66. Torres, our backup keeper, moved up 4 to a 63. I think he's going to be a pretty good. We got him also as a free agent. He's only 18, as you can see. But I should point out, when you see the youth squad, we got a good-looking keeper prospect. Oxborough moved up 3 to a 60. Another guy I'm going to try to sell. Buttle moved up 4 to a 65. Luke James moved up 5 to a 75. He's got good stats. I mean, look at his balance, up to a 95. That is probably the highest of any individual stat on our team. Baldwin also moved up 5 to a 65. Jordan Richards, who I'm going to try to get rid of, moved up 3 to a 58. Bernardo moved up 4 to a 67. And lastly, Nana Welbeck moved up 3 to a 74. He's got really good physical stats, as you can see, like 6 of the 8 are in green. So he's got some good potential to move up even higher. Let's see here, what else? You want manager's office? I'll show you contracts first. As you can see, Nilsson, who's one of the guys we're trying to get rid of, he's the only guy with contract issues. Everybody else, I mean, then we only have 4 guys who are signed for 2 years out. And I probably will hold on and not bother re-signing any of those guys until they start, you know, demanding wage increases. And if I'm going to get rid of Hartley for whatever reason, then I don't really obviously need to worry about it. As you see, our transfer budget's at 1.7 million and we got about 5,000 in wage. I'm thinking about doing the little quote-unquote cheat again in regards to doing the financial takeover for next season so we can get some more money and possibly get a better scout. As you can see, our scout currently has 3-star experience and 4-star judgment. And I figure we'll probably have one of these guys, like this guy here who's 4-star. Maybe we'll get even better with some five stars. I think those obviously cost like $8 million, so we would definitely need to have the influx of cash in order to hire one of those guys. As for our youth squad, we have five guys now. Pause, who's he's probably the weakest of the group. I think when I first signed him on, as you can see, his strengths are really in terms of potential, but his overall potential is really not that great for what we're really looking for. This guy, he looks like he's gonna be the real deal. It looks like he's gonna be a striker, but with that potential, that's pretty good. Here's one of our goalkeepers. As you see, potential is 76 to 86. This guy also is looking really good. As you can see, a lot of these guys are American because that's where I put out the scout to. I think next time I'll probably put one out to, like, if I hire a second one, I'll probably put one out to like Brazil and one to England and see what we can come up with. I kind of would like to get about overall, maybe I might let go of that Aaron Pause guy, but our goal really is to try to get maybe like 10 to 12 players on the U squad. But Kevin Carr looks pretty good, but he isn't really scouted, as you can see yet. We don't even know where he's going to play yet, so we'll see. That overall might actually come down. And Michael Lade is another guy who looks like he's got really good potential, but again, that sort of stuff might come down. As you see, he really doesn't have much. Both of these guys I haven't really fully scouted yet. This guy, the goalkeeper, as you can see, and then the big playmaker guy, look at all those numbers that he could go up to. He could be a stud to make him. And as you see, Pause is pretty well scouted. He's just not that good in terms of what he could become. That's really where we're at. As you see, we're pretty much at the end here. And the next, I think that's when the season starts there in July. That's pretty much it. I'll pick it up next season. Our first video, I don't know when. I might start it on our first game, just to showcase. And maybe by then we'll have some new guys in. We can show you that. Or at least I could talk about it. I don't really show that stuff. But anyways, so that's really about it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all in the Premier League.